Hi, I'm Danya Krishnamurthy, Program Manager within the Azure Active Directory team. Today, I'm going to be talking about monitoring and reporting within Azure Active Directory. First of all, why should I care? Why should you think about these logs when I'm talking about reporting and monitoring? Reporting and monitoring is one of the key aspects of running an IT organization. It helps you in determining your audit and compliance story. It helps you in troubleshooting issues, which whenever your end users run into trouble. It helps you in investigating security breaches, and it helps you be transparent and provide information to your organization by customizing reports on top of these logs and providing it to your executives. So, what do we have for Azure AD activity logs? We have two types of logs, sign-in logs and audit logs. Sign-in logs are mainly used for providing information around any sign-in activity that happens within your tenant. You will get information like which user logged into the tenant, which application did they access, where did they access it from, which device did they use, and it also answers questions like, was it a legacy auth, was it based on an MFA triggered event, are there any conditional access policies associated with the sign-in? All these rich set of information is provided through the sign-in logs for you. Audit logs, whereas, provides you information around management activities. Whether you add a user, add a group, add a role, remove users, give access to users, give access to a group, all of these are tracked through audit logs. So if when you want traceability and if you have to find out what happened for a specific user or a specific resource within the tenant, audit logs is the way to go. Before I jump into the demo of these two logs, I just wanted to give a quick overview on what it takes to see these reports. First of all, you need to have a premium-only license for the all sign-ins report. Any premium one and premium two tenants can access the all sign-ins report. For a single user sign-in, what this basically means is if you go to a single user profile and see the sign-ins from there through the Azure portal, you can actually access it for free. You don't need to have a premium one license or a premium two license. As for audit, it's available for everybody. The same licensing model that we have for the UI applies for the API as well. As for roles who can access these reports, you need to be either a global admin, a security reader, a report reader, or an application admin to access these reports. We do not have any scoping today. What this means is every field that you see in the logs or the reports can be seen by everybody in this particular role. So when you're assigning roles and when you're assigning users to these roles, be wary that all PII data and any other information within the reports can be seen by them. Now let's jump into a demo where I'll walk you through these two reports through the Azure portal, as well as walk you through it programmatically by using our MS Graph API. As you can see here, we have loaded the sign-ins for the last 7 days by default. You would be able to go and see all the information that is available here by just clicking on this particular row. You can see the sign-in info, which provides all the basic sign-in information like request ID, correlation ID, user information, IP address location, and the sign-in status. The client app field provides whether it's a legacy auth sign-in or whether it's a modern auth sign-in. In addition, you can use the date, user, and application columns to sort based on your needs. On the top here, you see that we have a set of filters available for you. You can also go and toggle the date as a local or UTC. Now, assuming that you want to have more filters available for this particular scenario that you're looking into, you can just click on the columns filter here, or columns button here, and you would be able to see a list of columns that you can actually choose. And as soon as you choose them, you will see that they will get added as a filter option for you. So we have provided this metadata-driven filter feature for you where you can just go and add filters as and when you find it to your needs. And then you can go and select any one of these. And then once you apply them, you will see the filtered results. In addition to this, you can also go into a sign-in status and look for sign-in failures specifically. And with sign-in failures, you will get extra information like sign-in error code and what was the failure reason. And if there's any remediation, we will provide that information here as well for you to take the next steps. In addition to this, you can find information like device info, MFA, and conditional access associated with a sign-in available in this view. This gives you the ability to easily go back and forth and find out and troubleshoot issues that you're looking into. In addition to all these features, we also have the ability for you to download the rows from the UI, which actually downloads up to 5,000 records. Due to this limitation, we have added another feature for you, which basically downloads a PowerShell script based on the filter criteria that you've selected here. So in this instance, I've selected the sign-in status as failure, and I've selected the last 7 days. I'm just going to go and change that to last 24 hours here and click apply. I'm going to click on the script button here, which downloads a script for me. I'm going to save this as a script here. I'm going to open it. And you will see that you will see the PowerShell script out here with the filter condition that you just selected. And all you need to do now is just run the script and it'll give you the output in a CSV file. In addition to this, we have a link to the Power BI content pack that I talked about, where you can just click on this link and it'll take you to the Power BI content pack that you can download and then access. We have a troubleshooting experience here where we just provide you top level troubleshooting topics for you to read and figure out before you actually go and create a support ticket. And this is how you can access the UI sign-ins UI through the Azure portal. You can also go and search by a specific user if you want to, or application as well. The one thing to note though is outside of the user and the application field, the rest of the fields are all case sensitive. So make sure that you provide the exact text when you are doing search on, for example, operating system, or when you add a location or region. The audit logs are of similar type, and audit logs have much more details from a management activity perspective. So if you go into the category, you will see the list of all the Azure AD services that we are auditing today, and you can go and select any one of them, and you can go and select a resource type and all the activities associated within that. So for example, if you're just interested in terms of use or declined terms of use, you can just select that, and then you can just go and select a date range and filter it out. Another example would be you can go into code directory, which is basically any directory related services, and you can say click on a user here and it will show all the user related activity that we are tracking. So you can select one and you can just click on apply and it will provide the report for you. Clicking on this will provide you additional details like what was the activity, when was it done, what's the status of the activity, who initiated this activity, and what was the target that was impacted by this activity, and whether some properties and other attributes were changed within that particular target, in this case, a user. All these information is available through download as well, and it is also available through our Microsoft Graph API. Now, let me quickly walk you through how you can get this through programmatic access. We have a list of documentation that we have provided here where you can go and set up an application, or you can set up an app certificate for you to authenticate to the MS Graph. Once you have set that up, we have samples and examples here on what you can do with this. So for example, we have a sign-in activity report API reference, which will tell you all the properties and attributes that are associated within this particular API. And you can just go and apply this and write a PowerShell script in the same order that I showed you a few minutes back, and then just run it to get an output either in JSON format or CSV format. You can also write a C# code and call this REST API to get the information that you're looking for. All these are documented and is available through our doc site. There is audit and there is sign-ins, both of which are available today. Now that we have gone through the demo, here's another way you can access these reports. We have created an Azure AD content pack, which actually gives you the ability to download these reports immediately within minutes and get a rich set of visualized dashboard view for you. With this, you can share this information within your organization within minutes. This Power BI content pack has app usage, sign-ins by location, SSPR usage, device usage, and much more that you can easily access. The only gotcha for this one, or the caveat, is it doesn't work for large-sized tenants. Use smaller date range when you're trying to access this for large-sized tenants. Now let's jump into a demo. You're now in the app.powerbi.com site. So go and click here, click Get Data, and you'll see something called Service Content Packs. click on the service content packs and search for Azure Active Directory Activity Logs. Click on Get It Now. The content pack will load and give you two parameters to input. One is the number of days for which you want to pull the data. So I'm going to just say 7 here. And it'll ask you to enter your tenant information. So you just enter your tenant name. You click on Next. And the authentication method that we have is OAuth. There's nothing to select here. So you just sign in into your tenant. And it'll start importing the data. This will take about a minute or two, depending on the size of your tenant. So wait until the import data icon goes off, and you will see the Azure Active Directory activity logs light up. Click on the Azure Active Directory activity logs, and it loads the pre-built dashboard that comes with the content pack. As you can see here, the dashboard contains a list of reports. You can click on any one of them, which will take you to the corresponding report within the content pack. So in this example, I'm going into user sign-ins, and here you can see the total number of sign-ins, the apps, and the total unique users in your tenant. In addition, you will see where are they logging in from, which location, and you'll also get information on success and failures as well. You can easily go here and change this view, for example. So if you don't want to have this as a chart and you would like to change this, you can go in here and you can just change the visual filter here, depending on what you're looking for. You can also go and export this data, and you can also go and just drill into this data depending on what you're looking for. There are some other reports like device sign-ins, which gives you a device view of the sign-in. So it gives you an idea on how which OS is the most used, which browser is the most used. It gives you information on unique users per app. So it gives you an idea on which users, which are your top users for what app. It also gives you app trends and usage, like how many apps are being used and who are using them exactly, and which location does the app sign-in have. So all this information can be got within minutes using the Azure AD Power BI content pack. You can go and change the dates to last 24 hours or last 2 days, depending on what you're looking for. You can also go and filter and say, hey, I want to just look at all the Azure portal related sign-ins, and you'll be able to see all of them, and you will find out from where they are signing in. So this gives you a very easy way to find out what's going on, and it also helps you understand how your data looks within your tenant. Just remember, for large-scale tenants, keep a very low date range or a very small date range because the report won't load otherwise.